There's nothing like a good old penny hunt to kick off 2023. Hey everyone, it's Rob Finds Treasure. Welcome back to my channel. We have a $2 penny hunt to kick off 2023. Now, obviously, I don't expect to find any silver for the silver jar, but hopefully you can find a penny to slot in the album. Through the first 215 boxes hunted, we're only missing 29 of those pennies to complete this book. I also don't expect to find any of the key dates or semi-key dates, but there are findable cents in here, and so I figured, why not hunt a couple more boxes and see if we can score some old Wheaties and something for the book. This is going to be boxes 216 and 217 of the series, and it's episode number 117 already. I will say in advance, I do plan on hunting at least 250 boxes before I retire this book, so hopefully we can grab a couple more slaughters before we get to the 250th box. I've already popped the top of this Chase Bank box because I had to make sure it was circulated since, and it is. And of course, this box, I can see by the holes in the bottom, we have circulated cents already. So we definitely have a 100 roll hunt today, and I'm eager to get started. Now I'll give you a look at the book at the end when I compare the finds to it to see if we have any additions and or upgrades. For now, we'll slide out of the way and we're gonna get right to the hunt. Let's see if we can score a nice Wheatie. We're on the very first roll of the box, and the fifth coin in of the box is going to be a wheat cent. And this is going to be a 1946 Denver to start the board. Roll number seven, wheat cent number two is going to be a 1958 Denver. We're on roll number 17, and we have wheat cent number three, and it does look like it could be an older one based on the reverse, as you guys can see. And it is older, but it's a Philadelphia minted 1926 Philadelphia. Let's just double check. It is 1926. It's a good year. Unfortunately, it's not one that we need. Would have been nice to grab that 26S though. We'll take it. First wheat cent pre-30s and third of the box. Roll number 25 marks the midpoint of the box, and we're going to have our fourth wheat cent and take a look at it. It's a beauty. Usually when they're this nice, they're in the 50s, but hopefully it's one from the 40s or earlier. And it's just going to be a last year 1958 Denver with a little bit of Tony. We'll take it though. Always nice seeing a pretty BU-ish looking wheat scent during your hunts. Roll number 26. We've got wheat scent number five, just a 1944 Philly, but it's in pretty nice shape overall. Same roll, and just a few coins after the last wheat cent, we have Un Centisimo de Balboa, República de Panama. And it's a 2018 with the Yuraca Warrior on the front. Beautiful looking coin. We'll take that and add it to the other two Canadians I've grabbed so far from the box. Roll 29. We now have wheat cent number six, and that's going to be a 1942 San Francisco. Well, that's going to do it for that first penny box. The last 21 rolls were cold as ice, no finds in those, which was kind of crazy because I thought we were going to get 8 to 10 based on where we were at the midpoint. Either way, it was a decent box for having the last 21 rolls being skunk rolls. We did get a pretty nice coin in the 20s, 1926 wheat cent, three in the 40s, and two in the 50s, including one pretty nice 1958 Denver minted wheat cent. Looks like it was an end coin at some point. I'll also point out, I didn't show it in the filming, but we did have a nice struck through Grease Air 1995. Let me put it under the scope for you, and you can see we don't have much of the date there. Even the first one is bad, and even some of this in Liberty is not really showing. It's weekly struck on In God We Trust, and when I flipped it around, it also had a pretty nice die crack from the Memorial Building. So kind of a cool find, not in the best shape, but I'm going to pull it aside, put it in my miscellaneous jar. We did get 2 pounds, 8 ounces of copper, so 2.5 pounds, not bad. We got 4 foreign coins, 3 were Canadians, and then we had 3 1959s that I pull aside just because they're transition year. No 69Ss, and again, light on the wheat cents. It was good hunting one of these boxes because it had been a bit since I hunted one of them, but now let's move on to box number 2 and see if we can get a pretty good amount of wheat cents and maybe something for the book. All right, we'll pop the top of this, hopefully. And there we have it. You know, it does look like it could be a slightly better copper box, but I don't have any fancy enders, so we're just going to get right into it. I'll bring you guys back in on my first find of box number two. We're on roll number seven of box number two, and we have our first wheat cent. And the good news is, it's another oldie. 1919 Philadelphia, though. No mint mark, but still nice seeing another older wheat cent and in pretty good condition overall for being 104 years old now. One from the teens, one from the 20s, seven on the board. We're on the 73rd roll of this hunt, and finally, in roll 23 of the box, we have our second wheat cent, which will now make eight overall. And that's a pretty nice 1950D. Wish it was the nickel we needed, though. Roll 74, wheat cent number nine. The ninth wheat cent of the hunt is a 1948 Philadelphia. Roll 78, and we are on our 10th wheat cent now for the two-box hunt, and that's going to be a 1953 Denver. Roll number 85, wheat cent number 11 is going to be facing us, and it's a 1945 Philadelphia. Roll number 93 is going to give us a find we periodically come across, another Lincoln Kennedy penny, 1968. I've covered these before. You guys who watch the channel should know what they are. They just put these in a little package that described the similarities between John F. Kennedy and Abraham Lincoln. So kind of a cool little thing. I actually have the original ones that are attached to the card, but always fun grabbing one. That one's in pretty nice shape too, and it's not often I find them in the 60s. Typically, they're in the 70s. We'll definitely take that as a miscellaneous find and get back to the hunt for more wheat cents. Well, we finished that two-box hunt, and unfortunately, they were pretty light boxes. Six finds in box one, five finds in box two, for a total of 11 wheat cent finds. Luckily, we got a good mix of dates, and most of them in the 40s, including a couple of oldies, a 1919 and a 1926. We don't need them, but they're good to see in the box, and we got a pretty nice 1958 Denver. It's not going to update the one in the book because I have a bright red example already in there. Couple of fun finds. We got that Lincoln Kennedy penny from 1968 and that struck through grease cent from 1995 with that die crack on the reverse. As far as the Canadians went, we got five, including, I didn't film it, a 1957 Laureate portrait or a young head in pretty decent shape. So maybe that will be able to be used in the album. Let me see if that's, no, it's fine. And then we got that Panamanian coin, 2018. Looks really nice, actually. Five 1959s, no 1969s, and no bright and shiny red copper cents. As far as copper is concerned, I weighed it up. It's 5 pounds on the nose. So definitely 2.5 pounds in both boxes. We'll take that. That's good, although the wheat cents weren't that plentiful. Let me go ahead and compare the finds to the book, although I can pretty much tell you this late in the game on box 217, we don't have any upgrades or additions, but I need to double check before I say no. I'll be back in a second with a look at the book and some final thoughts on the hunt. We have compared the finds to the album, and as expected, no additions, no upgrades. So now, after 217 boxes hunted, we're stuck at 205 of the 234 cents. And like I said before, I'm planning on keeping this episode or series going until box 250. And if for some reason we get stuck and we don't get any more cents at 250, I'll go ahead and stop this one and probably start a new book to see how far we get along for the next 250 boxes. On top of that, I do plan on starting a Canadian cent album. I have kept every one of the Canadian cents we have found since the 100th episode. So this is technically 17 episodes worth of Canadian cents so far. And again, that'll be a series down the road. Hopefully, despite the lack of upgrades and additions, you guys still enjoyed this two-box hunt. If you did, I definitely would appreciate that thumbs up. And as always, everyone, happy hunting, and thanks for watching.